If, for whatever reason, you still play on a monitor with no variable refresh rate like me, there are at least two quirky synchronization options that avoid tearing like Vsync, but have lower input lag: RTSS Scanline Sync and Low-Lag Vsync ON. Since the former is way more finicky to set up, as can be seen in my video about it, I've finally decided to guide you through the configuration of the latter. The first step is to define the real refresh rate of your monitor. So, close all applications, open your primary browser, make sure it's using hardware acceleration, go to testufo.com/refreshrate, select 6 decimal digits, and let it run for 5 minutes. After they have passed, write down the last value shown. Then, overwrite the link with displayhz.com, let it run again for 5 minutes, and note the end value. Finally, repeat these tests with another browser to double check the results. Your actual refresh rate is defined by those four values rounded down to 4 decimal places, e.g. mine is 60.0015 Hz. The second step is to compute some differences. From your refresh rate, subtract these 5 values. What you'll get are 5 alternative frame rate limits to type into the corresponding box of RTSS. So, how to choose? For its balance in terms of in-game stuttering properties, the recommended limit is that obtained from a value of 0.01. But because each system and game can behave differently, you may have to experiment a little with them, and maybe try a few in between. Personally, I've never had or noticed any particular problems with 0.01. The third step is to configure RTSS and NVCP. Therefore, open RTSS, add the game.exe, and set the chosen FPS limit. Then open the NVCP, and for that same game.exe set low latency mode to on, power management mode to prefer maximum performance, and vertical synchronization to on. The fourth and final step is to change the in-game settings. Simply uncap the frame rate and disable Vsync, as they have already been set in RTSS and NVCP, respectively. And that's all. Now, a quick in-game demonstration of Vsync on, frame cap on, Vsync plus frame cap on via graphics options, and our subject, low-lag Vsync on. Whereas the first three all produce unstable frame times, the latter is perfect, thanks to RTSS accuracy. Moreover, the frame time mess due to the loading of the next area is reduced to a single hiccup. Thus, I cannot help but encourage you to try it ASAP. Many thanks for tuning in and fare you well for now.